Hey, this is Travis the TAO Templar with TAO Stats. What is Dynamic TAO? Dynamic TAO, or DTAO, is the third major upgrade in the Bittensor network. The first major upgrade was Fini, allowing for the delegation of stake to validators. Then came Revolution, which permissionlessly allowed anyone to create their own subnet or commodity on Bittensor. We have seen massive growth since the subnets upgrade. This next major upgrade decentralizes emission allocation and commodity valuation. Remember, miners do the work, validators check and grant access to the work, subnet owners control the work, and stakers judge the value of the work. Currently, all validators vote to determine subnet emissions. Their vote is weighted based on how much TAO is staked to them. That is, their own TAO plus TAO from their stakers. Sort of like a representative democracy. This has worked well, as top validators have a large vested interest in the network and want to see it grow. However, there are two major issues to fix. As the network has grown, validators have had a very difficult time allocating value to subnets, as there are many aspects to consider. As the cost of registering subnets increased, validators helped fund subnet registrations, and some became subnet owners. These roles make validators' subnet emissions vote biased in favor of their own subnets. As a result, for subnet owners, cultivating relationships with top validators was sometimes seen as more important than value and quality. Dynamic TAO was conceived as a solution to these problems. Dynamic TAO decentralizes the power to allocate emissions to all network participants, allowing all participants to have an active say in the direction of the network. Instead of having large validators decide emissions, stakers now directly decide the flow of subnet emissions. Essentially, moving the network from a representative democracy to a direct democracy. Each subnet now has its own token internal to Bittensor, called the subnet's alpha token. Instead of staking rewards being distributed in TAO, stakers will receive alpha tokens based on the subnets they support. Alpha tokens have value relative to TAO and can be swapped for TAO. The value of those tokens is based on the demand from stakers, based on market forces. This means that stakers have the potential for increased returns if the subnets they choose increase in value. Stakers also have the potential to incur losses if they choose subnets that perform poorly. There is still a safe staking option called root staking, where you can stake to a validator on subnet 0 and receive a no-risk APR in TAO. But as the usage of alpha increases over time, this safe staking reward will decrease proportionally. Root staking will remain safe, but its APR will continually decrease over time. We will cover the details of how users delegate stake to validators and subnets in another video, but what is important to understand is that the emissions and value of each subnet will be determined by the demand for its alpha token, pegged against the base asset, TAO. We will also go into more detail in a separate video on how the liquidity pools for alpha work and how they evolve over time, but the main takeaways for TAO holders are as follows. When Dynamic TAO goes live, you do not have to do anything. Your TAO will stay root staked to subnet 0. You will continue to receive dividends in TAO. Over time, if you do nothing, the amount of dividends you receive will start to decrease. Over time, you are incentivized to start to swap some of your staked TAO for alpha tokens in subnets you believe show signs of growth or value, and in return accumulate that alpha token in place of TAO. You'll be speculating that your alpha tokens will increase in value against TAO, thus making you a greater sum of TAO than had you done nothing. Easy-to-use tools will be deployed with Dynamic TAO to allow you to perform these actions. The initial launch will likely see a lot of early volatility, and inexperienced users are advised not to deploy large amounts of funds into alpha before they understand the mechanisms at play, as there will be large slippage due to initial low liquidity. And then lastly, education is key in terms of judging subnet value and how to interact and profit from the network. At TAO Stats, we are committed to making this evolution as informative and as easy as possible as we step into this next phase of growth. Dynamic TAO stimulates network growth. It allows for an infinite expansion of subnets, it lowers the barriers of entry, and it allows for evolutions in subnet design and revenue models. We are very excited and looking forward to the future together.